Assalamu alaikum and hi everyone, this is AW Exotica with yet another amazing video for you guys. This time it's an addition to the Camera Basics series. I've done two videos already, one on shutter speed and the other on aperture. This video is about ISO. It's in continuation to the previous two videos that I've done. Go check them out. They are really amazing videos for Camera Basics or beginner photographers. So today we're going to talk about ISO, what ISO is, what it does, how it functions, how it affects your image, and how to control the ISO inside your camera. If you're new to the channel, please leave a like, do subscribe, turn on those bell notification icons so that you don't miss out on any of the good stuff. Without any further waiting to do, let's get you inside the video. So ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to our very first question, what ISO is. ISO is actually an abbreviation for the International Organization for Standardization. It's an organization that standardizes sensitivity settings for cameras or the sensors inside them. Well, this brings us to another question. How is the ISO used by the camera? Now the ISO is basically image sensitivity, the sensitivity of your sensor to light. As you increase the ISO, the sensor becomes more sensitive to light, and as you decrease the ISO, the sensor becomes less sensitive to light. Now, the ISO values given inside the camera range from 50 to 12,800 in some cameras, 50 being the lowest, or 100 in some cameras, which is known as the native or base ISO, and 12,800 even plus than that is the highest ISO settings for immense amount of sensitivity inside your camera or of the sensor itself. Another thing, how does exposure affect the image inside your camera? How it affects the quality of the image inside your camera? Well, like shutter speed and aperture, ISO values also correspond to exposure stops inside the camera itself. So if you are increasing your ISO from 100 to 200, that is one stop increase in exposure inside your camera. And if you increase the value from 100 to 400, that is four stops. And similarly, from 100 to 6400, that is an increase of six stops of exposure inside your camera. Now, another question that comes to our mind is how ISO affects image quality. Well, if you're using a higher ISO, that is going to introduce a lot of noise and grain inside your image. That is basically going to spoil the details inside your image, the highlights and shadows, all of the details that you're trying to capture inside an image. So higher ISOs normally damage the image. Lower ISOs, however, give you the best possible quality that the camera sensor is offering you, or the camera is offering you. So it is always recommended to use the lowest possible ISO to get that best quality image, to get to retain those details in highlights and shadows of your image. So it is always recommended to use the least possible ISO inside your cameras. If you really want to control the exposure inside your camera, you're recommended to play with the aperture and shutter speed. If you cannot control the correct exposure and you get handicapped, only then you should increase or crank up your ISO inside your camera. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the last question that needs to be answered today is how to choose correct ISO inside your camera for different situations. Inside your camera, there are settings that through which you can manually choose the ISO value from 100 to whatever maximum value that the camera offers. Let's come to the point. You ought to use higher ISOs in situations of low light environment, where there is very less light, there is a dark environment, shooting outdoors at night, and there is very less ambient light that is lighting up your subject. In those cases, you're recommended to use a higher ISO value. Or perhaps you're trying to shoot a moving subject and you want to capture that action, you want to slow the you want to freeze the motion of perhaps a soccer player or a cricket player or a football player. In those situations, if you crank up your ISO really high, you're able to increase your shutter speed. Okay, now coming over to low ISO settings. You use low ISO wherever there is ample amount of light available. There is, for example, you're shooting outdoors in broad daylight where there is a lot of sunlight available. You don't need to use a higher value of ISO. So you are advised to keep your ISO at the native or base ISO level inside your camera, that is 100 or 50. You can also use lower ISO indoors if you're having ample amount of ambient light or artificial light, which is, lightening up your subject. Like right now, I'm using this light for my studio setup, which is lightening me up. So this light basically allows me to lower my ISO and get the best possible image or video quality out of this camera. That's pretty much it for today's video. Hope you liked it, hope you enjoyed it. This was the third video amongst the camera basic series that I have made on my channel. Do watch the other two videos. One is about aperture and the other is about shutter speed. If you like this video, do hit the like button, do subscribe. Don't forget to turn on the bell notification icon so that you don't miss out on anything. I'll be coming up with a lot of interesting videos in future as well for you guys. So that's pretty much it. This is AW Pipsotica signing off. See you in another video. Ciao.